for second-year University of Southern Mississippi graduate student Christina Parazio, studying dolphins off the Mississippi coast has become second nature.
We go six times a month. We have four trips to the Mississippi Sound and two to Louisiana marshes.
Marine Mammal Behavior and Cognition Lab Director Dr. Stan Kuczaj oversees the study of dolphins at the lab.
A lot of students are willing to put a lot of hard work and effort into it. I mean, it sounds very romantic when you think, oh, I'm going to work with dolphins, but it's like any scientific process. There's a lot of work and a lot of drudgery involved, but the outcomes are we learn a lot of interesting things.
Over the past decade, the program has identified more than 1,400 individual dolphins. Some live in the Mississippi Sound, while others are simply passing through. Sorting out the residency patterns and habitat use of the sound is one of the objectives of the lab. And the fascination with dolphins just keeps growing.
People love dolphins. And because of that, I mean, I love dolphins too. I'm one of those people that love dolphins. But because of that, what we find is lots and lots of interest. So for example, when we started the marine mammal program here, and it actually started when I came in 1996, and now we get many more applicants for the graduate program than we can admit. It's a very popular program. We have students coming from all over the world.
The study area is located along the Mississippi Barrier Islands, essentially north and south of Horn Island through Cat Island. Students also get to study dolphins in captivity in locations across the world, from Honduras to California and Florida.
The study with captive animals is very important because we can get more information on specific aspects of dolphin behavior and dolphin cognition.
And these findings have catapulted Kuczaj into a position of authority on the subject of dolphin behavior, sought after for documentaries and research all across the world.
We get a lot of work published, and that work gets out there, and so people learn about what we're doing. In the last few years, we've been associated with a number of documentaries, which also gets the name of the lab and the university out there.
And while research has led to a number of fascinating discoveries, there's much more work to be done.
Humans aren't going away. And bottlenose dolphins, which are the species that we've been talking about, inhabit the coastlines of areas, and so they're most likely to have interactions with humans. And most of the time, those interactions are very positive. What we worry about is, because people love dolphins, that they do things which may not necessarily be good for the dolphins. They don't mean to hurt the dolphins, but they could accidentally do that.
And this psychology professor believes the more we learn about these creatures of the sea, the more we can connect the world of humans and dolphins. From the University of Southern Mississippi, I'm Layla Essery.